Dear student, we'll start with topic that is translation. Translation is a process by which mRNA carrying information from DNA is being used for synthesis of protein. Protein. Now for translation, we need some machinery. First of all, mRNA, then amino acid, then tRNA, then ribosome. Now if you have to arrange in order to requirement, first we need mRNA, then we need ribosome, third we need tRNA, which is charged. Mean it is being labeled, it is labeled with amino acid. Now first of all, we start with the translation in case of prokaryote. Prokaryotic translation. Now in case of prokaryote, the site where our ribosome, the site where ribosome bind to mRNA is known as ribosome binding site. Now in case of prokaryote, the site is known as Shine Delgarno sequence. Now the Shine Delgarno sequence is present 8 base pair away from the start codon, that is AUG. For upstream, it is here the Shine Delgarno sequence, where ribosome small subunit will bind. The ribosome in case of prokaryotes is of 70s, which comprises two further subunit, one is 30s, one is 50s. 30s subunit has further subunit, that is 16s rRNA, which has complementary sequence to that of Shine Delgarno sequence. So the small subunit of ribosome through 16S rRNA sequence will bind to the mRNA at Shine Delgarno sequence. Now the sequence that is present on mRNA, we are talking about Shine Delgarno sequence, is A C C U C C U U A, which is present on mRNA. Approximately 8 base pair away from the start codon to the upstream. Now the 16S RNA sequence, 16S rRNA sequence is G G A G and C. Sorry, C, G. So here this sequence, which is present on 16S RNA, a subunit of 30S RNA, complement with the Schindler RNA sequence. In this way, the ribosome will bind to the ribosome binds with mRNA in case of prokaryote. Now the translation in case of prokaryote will divide into three phases. One is initiation, elongation and termination. Prokaryotic translation. So in case of initiation, certain factors are required that we call initiation factor. Factors are required that is called initiation factors. So here is three initiation factor: IF1, IF2 and IF3. IF1, 2 and 3. Now suppose here is a small subunit of ribosome. Now this IF1 will bind to site that will become A site. So IF1 will bind here, that will become site A. Suppose here the IF1 will bind, and IF2, it will bind here and it interact with the three IF2 interact three things. One is IF1, another one is ribosome, and third is formylated methionine tRNA, formylated methionine tRNA. So here suppose here is IF2. Now this IF3, this bind to site that is E site, and it prevent the association of large subunit. So FI1 will bind to site that become site A, now next to site E, and this IF3 will prevent the association of large subunit with the small subunit. Now, as you can see, it is a complex of ribosome which is being dissociated with the into 50S and 30S subunit. Now, this 30S subunit initially
prepared to form an initiation complex that we call 30S initiation complex. Now how it will be done. So first of all, what happened, this IF3 will bind to small subunit and prevent its reassociation with the large subunit. So the large subunit will not able to bind with the small subunit. Now once IF3 get bound with the small subunit, it's ready to bound with the IF1, IF2 and GTP also. This IF1 will bound to site that will become site A. Neighbor to that is P and then E. Now the A site is being accompanied by or joined by IF1, initiation factor 1, and then IF2 will bound to this ribosome and it interact with ribosome, IF1 and GTP. GTP also bound with the IF2. After that, it's turn of first tRNA, that is charged tRNA. First charged tRNA to join the ribosome. Now let's say here is a charged tRNA which get bound with a small subunit and that site become P site. Next to that E site, here it is A site. So let's get revised once again. So this is a complete set of ribosome which get dissociate into large subunit and small subunit, and small subunit is available for the preparation of a initiation complex that we call 30S initiation complex. Now this IF3 will bound to the ribosome and prevent its reassociation with the large subunit. Now this subunit, that is 30S subunit, will bind with the other initiation factor, that is IF2, IF1 and GTP also. IF1 will bound to site that will become A site, and also this IF2 will interact with the three component, that is first one is your IF1, GTP and ribosome. Okay, and GTP also. Okay, GTP I already said. Now formation of complex of a small subunit with IF1, IF2, GTP, formylated methionine and IF3 is known as 30S initiation complex. Once the initiation complex is formed, it stimulates the release of IF3, and once the IF3 is released, now as we know the IF3 prevent the association of large subunit with a small subunit. Now IF3 is released, so it lead to formation of complex of large subunit with a small subunit, and once a small large subunit joined with a small subunit, the GTPase activity of IF2 is stimulated, which cause hydrolysis of GTP into GDP. Once a GTP is converted into GDP, the release of IF2 GDP take place, IF1 take place. So and it lead to formation of 70S initiation complex. It left with only the first tRNA, that is formylated methionine.
Now in case of elongation, as we have studied in initiation, formation of 70S initiation complex in which small subunit, the small subunit is linked with the large subunit, and there is an mRNA also, and there is a first tRNA which is placed at P site, and the first tRNA is linked, or you can say charged with amino acid, that is formylated methionine. Now the translation elongation in case of prokaryotic is divided into three steps: first, second and third. In case of first, there is a loading of correct tRNA which is charged tRNA at the A site. Then in the next step, there is a formation of peptide bond formation by an enzyme, that is peptide transferases, in which the amino acid which is being linked with tRNA on P site is transferred to the tRNA which is linked at the A site. Now you can see here here, as it is seen in black dot, here is the red dot. Now the black dot is shifted to the red dot. Now there is a translocation of amino acid from P site to the A site by enzyme peptide transferases. And the third step is translocation. In case of translocation, the tRNA at A site, which is charged with the amino acid. Now the tRNA at P site is empty without any amino acid, has to shift from P to E site and this A to P site. Now you can see if it is P, if it is A, P and E. Now the amino acid is shifted from A to P site and P to E site. Okay, now there's a factors involved in the elongation. Now first factor is elongation factor TU. Now this elongation factor TU bind with GTP and this factor bring the charged tRNA at the A site. So you can say the tRNA is linked with elongation factor TU GTP and it bond with the at the A site. Means it help tRNA to load at A site. Now once it is being loaded, the last factor has a factor binding site. It has a factor binding site, or you can say factor binding center. Now the factor binding center has a GTPase activity which hydrolyzes GTP bonded with the elongation factor TU GTP, and after hydrolysis it will become GDP. Now this elongation factor TU GDP linked with GTP, which is very less affinity, or say it lose affinity to bind with the tRNA, so it will be removed from the complex. So I repeat, this elongation factor TU GTP bonded with the tRNA, that is charged tRNA, and help in a loading to A site. After loading, this GDP get hydrolyzed into GDP, and once it is being hydrolyzed to GDP, this elongation factor TU lose its affinity for this tRNA or the complex, and it will be removed like this. So it will be moved out from the complex. Now next is translocation. In case of translocation, next step is peptidyl bond transferase action. Now in peptide bond formation, the enzyme that is peptidyl transferases tRNA, which is placed on P site, is transferred to the A site. Then here you can see transfer take place. Then translocation is carried by the factor, that is elongation factor G. It also binds with the GTP. Once it is being loaded on the this complex, then the GTP come in contact with the factor binding site or factor binding center on the large subunit of ribosome, and it convert GTP into GDP. Once this conversion take place, there's change in conformation of this factor, elongation factor G, and which cause the movement of these tRNA from A to P site and this P to E site.